Hello guys, welcome to the WebAppick channel. In this video, we'll learn how to create a WooCommerce product feed for Idealo. So without further ado, let's jump in and learn how exactly we can do this. To create a new feed for Idealo, let's go to our plugin CTX Feed and then click on New Feed. Once you have done that, let's choose the country. In this case, let's choose Germany. And then the template we'll be choosing here is Idealo. As you can see, we've got the template covered here. Let's give it a file name, idealo1. I'm going to keep the file type as CSV and include all the variations. If we scroll down, we can see all the different attributes that are required that has been pre-populated by our template right here. So let's go through all these attributes right now. As you can see, since we've chosen the Idealo template, the plugin has pre-populated all the Idealo required attributes. Let's go through the attributes one at a time. First, we have got the SKU. The SKU is the article number of the item in the shop. This is generally a unique number and it is saved under the product right here under inventory. As you can see, this product has this particular SKU. So using the SKU, you can uniquely identify an item or a product. Next, we have got the title, which is pretty self-explanatory, which is the product title of the item. And then you've got a little bit of the description of the item. And then you have prices, and this price includes the VAT. Right now, as you can see, you've chosen the value for price. The suffix shouldn't be BDT, it should be euros instead. So I'm going to type in euro. There we go. The next is the image URL. And here, this is bringing out the comma separated value for the image URL from our products. Next, we've got the delivery time. The delivery time is the time until the goods will arrive to the customer. For this, we have chose a pattern or a static value, as you can see right here. And we have said that it's going to take 1 to 3 working days. If you want, you can change this to 1 to 5 or however you want it to be according to your delivery time. Next, we have got the category path. Providing this value will allow us the time to map the appropriate Idealo categories. We need to make sure the path is starting at the main category. So as you can see, we've got product category here. To map your Idealo product categories, all you need to do is go to category mapping. Under category mapping, as you can see, I've already created some categories for Idealo right here. If you go and edit, you will see for the categories that we have in our system, I have created the full path for them. As you can see, for every single path, I've made sure the path starts with the main category right here. So similarly, according to the requirements of Idealo, you can create your product categories right here. Once you have created the product category, you can go click here, scroll down, and choose the product category that you have just created. As you can see here, I found Idealo categories. So I'll choose that. The next item that we have is our product URL. As you can see, this will bring it up right here. Now let's move on to the other attributes. The brand is basically the name of the manufacturer for the product or the offer that we have. Right now, as you can see, it is set to pattern, which is basically giving us a static value. If we choose this pattern or static value, every single item that we have in our feed is going to have the same brand name. Let's say if we put in Nike, that means all the product here will come up as Nike. However, if we wanted, we can also choose attribute and make sure every single attribute or product or offering is giving us a different value. To do that, all you need to do is go into your products. Under here, as you can see, we have brand by CTX Feed, which is enabled. You can choose the brands available here, or you can choose to add a new brand. Once you've done that, all you have to do is go back to your feed and make sure under attributes, you choose brand by CTX Feed. There you go. If you choose that, that means whatever brand you've chosen under your product is what's going to come up in the feed. Let's say, for example, for this item, belt is going to come up as Gucci brand. The next attribute that we have is checkout. Checkout defines if the offer is available for direct purchase or not. The values that it accepts are true, ja, or 1. So if you want, you can put in true or you can put in ja. Or you can use the number 1. If this value is omitted or left clear, that means the offering is not clear for direct purchase. Similar to a previous attribute, if we use this pattern or static value, that means any value that we put here is going to be the same for all the different products in our feed. If you want, we can also dynamically set this up under products. To set this up individually under products, this is what we need to do. To use attribute here instead of pattern, let's go ahead and see how we can create a new attribute. To create a new attribute, go to products and then click on attributes. Once you're here under attributes, let's go ahead and create a new attribute. Let's name it checkout Idealo, and let's go ahead and add this attribute. Once you have added the attribute, you can go ahead and configure its terms. As you can see, the terms that we had was true, yeah, or one. For now, I'm going to use the term true. Let's do that, and let's go ahead and add that. Perfect. It's all set up right now. So now if we go under edit product, let's go ahead and refresh the page. And if we go down here under attributes, if we click on this drop down button, you'll see Idealo checkout. There we go. And we can add this for our product. And under here, we can add the term true or keep it as empty. Let's go ahead, save the attribute. Now, when you go back to our feed, all we have to do is make sure we choose attribute and select the attribute right here. Since I've just recently created this attribute, let's go ahead and clear the cache right here. Boom, once it's done, let's scroll down. Let's go to checkout, attribute, and let's find that attribute that we've just created. There you go. As you can see under product attributes, we can see checkout Idealo. We can go ahead and choose that. The next attribute that we have is EANs, which is basically the GTIN or the EAN of the offer. Right now, similarly, if it's set to pattern, all the products will have the same EANs. Since we don't want that to happen, we can go ahead and choose attribute. Once you've chosen attribute, you can scroll down and choose either the GTN or EAN of the product. For these options to be available, these custom fields, you need to go to settings, which is right here, and scroll all the way down and make sure you have the GTN and the EAN enabled right here. And once you've done that, when you go to edit product, under inventory, you'll see the fields showing up. Now you can complete these values according to your needs for different products. So I'm going to set this up as attribute and I will choose EAN. Perfect. Now we have the fulfillment type. There are different attributes and values Idealo accepts for this. If you use pattern, once again, every single product will have the same fulfillment type. Here, as you can see, I've created another attribute with the name fulfill underscore Idealo, and I've populated with all the values accepted by Idealo. We've got download, freight forward, letter, and parcel service. So now if we go back to our feed, if we scroll down, under here, we can use the attribute and we can populate it with the new attribute that we have just created. There you go, fulfill underscore Idealo. And accordingly, we can populate each of the products with the different values that we have added. Next, we have got the checkout limit per period. This is the max number of this offer available by a direct purchase per day. For this, we can keep it as pattern. And let's say for all items, the maximum number you can purchase is 3. Similar to the other attributes for size and color, I'm going to select the attributes here. Let's scroll down and let's see if we can find size. Perfect. And we're going to add color as well. Our feed is more or less ready. If you want to add new attributes that are optional, you can go ahead and click on this button right here. So click on add new attribute. Let's say, for example, we're going to add free return days and let's keep it as a static value. And let's say for 14 days, you can return it. Let's go ahead, update and generate this feed. Voila, as you can see, our feed is complete and this is the feed URL. Once your feed file is ready, now you're ready to go to Idealo, log in, go to the offers or menu tab, and then reach out to the customer support team to validate your file. Once your file is validated, you should see all your products from the feed coming through. There you go, guys. Now you know how to create a WooCommerce product feed for Idealo. If you have any questions or issues, you're welcome to reach out to us at support@webappick.com. I hope you guys found this video useful. Please leave a like and subscribe to this channel for more videos like this. I hope everybody has a good day. Thank you very much.